Hello and welcome to the third video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, we are going to take a closer look at layers and the timeline panel in Adobe After Effects. In the previous episode, I introduced you to the Adobe After Effects interface, where I briefly introduced you to the timeline panel. Now, this panel is one of the most important panels in this program. There's a lot to learn and understand about this panel, which is important before we move on in this course. In this video, we are going to be covering the following topics: layers, the time indicator, RAM preview, and the timeline work area. After this video, you will get a better understanding of how all of this works and hopefully feel more comfortable moving forward. So let's start with the layers. Now, if you're completely new to After Effects, you will soon come to realize that layers are the fundamental basis for any composition created in After Effects. And these layers are managed in the timeline panel. Everything we see visually in the composition panel above is coordinated, managed, and composed in the timeline panel below. So here is the timeline panel at the bottom of the interface, and inside are all the layers making up this composition. To follow along with this tutorial, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this video. This can be found in the introduction folder in the project folder. You can download this project folder for a small fee. The download link with instructions is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into the S1 introduction folder, then into the third folder, layers and the timeline panel, and open the tower bridge file inside, and you should have something that looks like this. So what we are looking at here inside the timeline panel is a timeline composition. Up in the visual composition panel above, we can see an arrangement of visual objects in the canvas area that make up this composition. We have an illustration, some shapes, and we have some type elements. Now, if we look closely in the timeline panel, we can see that each element that exists in the canvas area above is represented by its own individual layer, which are all stacked on top of each other in rows as bars. Now, if I move my mouse cursor over the top of the panel, we will see the cursor change. This is indicating I can click and drag up or down to increase the visibility of the layers within. However, this will make the composition panel smaller, but for now, I want us to focus on the layers in the timeline panel, so I'll drag this up a little bit like so. In this instance, I have a few layers which I still can't see. On the far right of the timeline panel, you will see a slider, which you can drag up or down to see more of the layers within. Or, if you have a scroller on your mouse, you can place your mouse cursor into the timeline panel and scroll using that. So here we can see there are quite a few layers. Each layer has a name with an icon to the left of this to give us a quick preview as to what type of element is on that layer, such as a video, an image, a shape, or audio. To the right of these are a series of switches and modes that can be applied to the layer, and over on the far left we have the visibility switches to toggle the visibility of layers and lock layers on and off in the visual composition panel above. The way the timeline panel works is by stacking layers on top of each other in a hierarchy, quite like stacking sheets of paper on top of each other. Whichever layer is at the top of the layer stack is the layer which will have the most visibility, and the layer at the bottom will have the least visibility, hidden by any layer which happens to be above it. Layers are created here in the timeline when an item is dragged in from the project panel on the left, or created using the tools on the top bar, such as the type or shape elements. Now, in After Effects, we don't only work with hierarchy, but we also have to work with time. Notice the numbers across the top of the panel on the right. This represents the length of time of this composition. As we can see here, by the number indicator across the timeline, This composition is currently 36 seconds long, so everything in this composition occurs within 36 seconds. You will also notice that these layer bars are set to different widths from left to right. This indicates their presence along the timeline. You can see, for example, that some layers are visible throughout most of the sequence, where some only for a short period. So now I want to bring your attention to the blue line here on our timeline. This represents a particular instance in our composition which is visible in the composition panel in the middle of our interface. If I come to the grabber at the top and drag left or right, we can move through time either back or forward. As you move, you will see the graphics changing in the composition above. You will also see the time change in the top left of the timeline panel in blue. This will clearly tell you at what time the current timeline indicator lies and where in the composition you are. Now, this time indicator is fundamental to using After Effects, and you will see later how we will be paying close attention to this to compose all animations in After Effects. Now, notice that as you move the bar from left to right, crossing over the layers in the timeline panel, you will see visual elements coming and going. It's important to note that whatever you see visually in the composition panel is linked to the position of this blue line, the current time indicator, here in the timeline panel. To edit the composition through time, we must use this time indicator and place it where appropriate along the timeline to create the composition. Now, if you click on a layer bar in the timeline panel, you will see that visual element selected in the composition window with the layer controls around it. However, if you click a layer bar that is before or after the blue line time indicator, you will notice that it is not selected or visible in the composition panel. Remember, you can only see in the visual composition panel where the blue line, the time indicator, is in the timeline panel. If there is a layer selected in the timeline panel you want to see in the composition panel, you will have to select the time indicator and move it on top of the layer you wish to see. Now, you may also notice that these layer bars are in different colors. In After Effects, we can change the color of the layer bars. This allows us to organize our layers visually. To do this, we can simply click on the colored square on the far left next to the layer name and select a color from the dropdown. Simple. So right now, we can see an arrangement of the layers from top to bottom. Remember, the way the timeline panel works is by stacking layers on top of each other in a hierarchy. Whichever layer is at the top of the layer stack is the layer which will have the most visibility, and the layer at the bottom will have the least visibility, hidden by any layer which appears to be above it. To change the hierarchy, we can simply click and hold on a layer name on the left and drag up or down. As we do that, we will see a blue line indicating where it will be placed upon release. Should you want to drag multiple layers at once, simply click on the first layer, then press and hold Command on Mac or Control on PC and click other layers. Once selected, you can then click and drag them wherever you want. Simple. So the last thing I want to show you about layers are the layer properties. Notice next to each layer name, over on the left, we can see a triangle pointing right. If we click this for one of the layers, we will reveal the layer properties. Let's look at this type layer, for example. Upon click, you will reveal the properties below, and here we can see text and transform. Now, it is really important to mention and for you to remember here that every layer, regardless of what kind of media object it is, be it an image, a shape, an audio file, or text layer, we will always see the transform property. If we drop this down, we will see the following: anchor point, position, scale, rotation, and opacity. These are the basic properties you can animate over time on any layer to create your video sequence. Now, if we take a look over here under the layer adjacent to the properties, you will notice these little shapes. Now, you may be wondering what these are. These are called keyframes, and these keyframes are what set the parameters for all effects over time, such as position, scale, rotation, and opacity over on the left here. As you begin with After Effects, you will learn that almost every effect you create is set with keyframes. And there is a lot to learn about keyframes, which we will be going into in more depth in the next video. but for now, keep in mind that it's from here we do basic animation. So above this, we see the contents dropdown. Now this is what varies depending on what type of layer it is. At a glance, you can see that there are lots of properties on a layer we can animate and customize. To close the layer properties, simply click on the triangle to the left of the layer name, and that will close. Remember, you can toggle this triangle to hide and reveal the properties. So the next topic I want to discuss with you is previewing. So far, I have shown you how to move through the timeline with the time indicator by clicking and dragging. But what if you want to preview the video composition to see how it looks in real time? To do this, we use what is called a RAM preview. So first, I'll carefully put my mouse cursor over the top of the timeline panel, look for the mouse cursor to change to the up and down arrow, and click and drag this down so I can see more of the visual composition panel above. Now, if I click on the timeline indicator and drag it back to the beginning of the timeline, on the keyboard, I will press spacebar. Upon click, you will see a red line start to move out from the blue time indicator line and across the timeline and preview the video sequence in real time in the composition panel above. Also, notice the green line that appears and builds across the timeline at the top. Now, this is called a RAM preview. It's called a RAM preview because After Effects uses the computer's RAM to preview the sequence. This green bar here represents how much has been loaded into RAM, and whatever is green should play smoothly. If I press spacebar again, this will stop the RAM preview. Notice how the time indicator also moves to where we stop the preview. You will also notice the green line stops. Upon stopping the RAM preview, you will also stop the preview loading into RAM. If I press spacebar again, it will continue. If I press it again, it will stop. Now, I can click on the timeline indicator, drag back to the start, press spacebar again, and I can watch the sequence again and again. Now, as you create your composition sequence in After Effects, you will be constantly RAM previewing your composition like this in order to test and make sure your animations are in time and you are happy with them. Now, it's important to mention that the more complex your animation sequence, for example, if you have lots going on in one instance, it's going to require more RAM and slow things down a little. If you have a computer with a fast processor and lots of RAM, this will work more smoothly. Though if you have a lower spec computer, this will be a slower process. Now, there is something that makes RAM preview more streamlined and less of a pain to use. In the last episode where I introduced you to the interface, I showed you the resolution factor here at the bottom of the composition panel. So right now this is set to full. This means full resolution of the preview in the visual composition here in the panel above. Now if I click this and select half, third or quarter, you will notice the visual comp become pixelated. Now if I click the time indicator and drag back to the start and press spacebar to activate the RAM preview, this will preview a lot more smoothly. This is because we have downgraded the resolution, which loads less information into the RAM preview. This puts less stress on the hardware and allows it to preview a lot smoother. As you create sequences in After Effects, you will be toggling this a lot in After Effects. You will find that as you work on your project, you will be working in half, third, or quarter resolution to test your sequences. And when you want to preview in full quality or focus on a particular part of your sequence to refine, you will toggle to full resolution. Now, another thing you will need to learn about the timeline panel is the work area. If you look closely just under the timeline number indicator, you will notice a bar with two blue ends, one here on the far left and one on the far right. On the end of each bar, we will see a blue grabber. As we place our mouse cursor over this, you will see the mouse cursor change. For example, I will click and drag the blue grabber on the far left and drag over to say 10 seconds. Next, I will click and drag the blue grabber on the far right and drag it into 16 seconds. So right now, I have set the work area between 10 and 16 seconds. Now, if I click and drag the time indicator into this work area space and press spacebar to activate the RAM preview, you will notice that the red line travels to the end of the work area and loops back to the start when it gets to the end. This bar, just under the timeline numbers, is the work area, and we use this work area in After Effects to focus on particular timeframes in our sequence. For now, I'll just press spacebar to stop the RAM preview. Something else you can do here is place your mouse cursor over the work area. Notice the mouse cursor changed to a left and right arrow. If I click and drag, I can move the work area across the timeline to another place, and then click the blue handles on the ends to tweak the work area time. Now we can use this work area to preview the entire sequence or right down to a second. And there will be many instances where we will want to focus on just a few seconds and loop a preview to make sure the animation or video sequence is exactly how we want it. So using the workspace area and the resolution factor, we can make previewing the composition in real time smooth and easy. These are very important things to remember when using After Effects, as you'll be using these a lot as you create a video sequence in After Effects. So this brings us to the end of the video. So to recap, the timeline panel allows us to focus on three things: determine layer order and hierarchy, timing and animation, and treat and manage individual composites through a motion sequence. So in this video, I discussed layers and how they work. What we are looking at here inside the timeline panel is a timeline composition, which contains all these layers for this particular animated sequence. In this instance, we are currently looking at a single timeline composition. Now, it's important to note that a simple project can include many individual timeline compositions to create an entire video presentation. It will help to think of compositions as individual video parts. Some animated sequences can be very complex and require lots of layers, so we can use compositions as a way to focus on particular sequences, organize and manage a project. In the next video, we will be taking a closer look at compositions, learning more about them and how they work to build a project in Adobe After Effects. So see you in the next video.